This Siyata Shemaiah, we're going to learn Yuma Daf Gimel. We're going to start four lines from the top of the Omud. And we're in the middle of a sugya. We saw on Daf Beis that the concept of Miluim, when there was the inauguration of the Mishkan, that there was a special Pasuk. The Pasuk writes that Aaron HaKohen had to separate himself from his home, come into the Mishkan for the duration of 7 days, in preparation for the 8th day of the Miluim, which was the time that they would start doing the Avodah in the Mishkan. And the Pasuk says regarding the Miluim, the Pasuk there said that Kasher Oso Bayoim Hazeh, the same as you did on this day, that you had a separation from the home, from other people, into the Mishkan. For the Miluim, Tzivo Hashem La'asois Lechapir Aleichem. Hashem commanded you to do for your atonement. And these words seem to be superfluous. The entire Pasuk seems to be superfluous. So then the Gemara told us that what the Pasuk was actually impressing on us was that in the same way as for Miluim, there was a halacha of prisha, of separation, so too it's la'asos lechaper aleichem, there's going to be other times that you're required min ha'Torah to do a separation. When is that? So the Gemara said, it was Rabbi Yochanan on Daf Beis Amud Aleph, said that la'asos is telling us that by Parah Aduma, the 7 days before the Kohen burnt the Parah Aduma, he would have to separate. And the Lechaper is referring to Yom Kippur. 7 days before Yom Kippur, the Kohen Gadol would separate himself, come to the Lishkas Parhedrin, which is what we saw in the Mishnah on Daf Beis Amud Aleph. And then the Gemara said on Daf Beis Amud Beis, who told you that Lechaper is referring to Yom Kippur? Maybe Lechaper is talking about Korban Yochid. And we said that that's not probable. How about the Yomim Tovim? So the Gemara discussed Pesach, Sukkos, Shmini Atzeres, and the Gemara explained with each case why it was not probable that the Pasuk of Lechaper is teaching us Prisha before those Yomim Tovim, and therefore we're left with Yom Kippur, which is what it says in our Mishnah. But the Gemara hasn't yet finished. Says the Gemara, Daf Gimel Omud Aleph, fourth line from the top of the Omud. Ve'ima Atzeres, maybe it's referring to the Yom Tov of Shavuos, that 7 days before Shavuos, the Kohen who was going to offer the Korban of Shavuos, of Yom Tov, would have to separate himself 7 days. The precious Shivas Yomim, the Shiva L'Yom Echotu, it's similar to the Miluim in as much as that it was 7 days separation in preparation for a single day of Korbanos. And the Gemara said before in Daf Beis Amud Beis that regarding Pesach and Sukkos, that wouldn't have been the case because there the Yom Tov is longer than a day, but Shavuos is just 1 day, similar to Miluim. So why are you saying that Yom Kippur, you have to do Prisha? Maybe it's not Yom Kippur, it's Shavuos. Answers the Gemara, Omer Reb Abba. Reb Abba says, Donim par echod va'ail echod, that Yom Kippur, which is a single ox and a single ram, is learnt, that means Yom Kippur, which has that halacha, is similar to Mipar Echod Vahel Echod to Miluim, where there also there was a single ox and a single ram. La Fuke Atzeres, in contrast to Shavuos, which is not similar to the Miluim, because with Shavuos you've got Shnei Elim Ninu, there were two rams. And obviously in Yom Kippur there's much more than just one ox and one ram. But that's for the Avodas Yom Kippur of Shavuos, of Yom Kippur, that's what there was. Par echod, ayel echod, the other korbonis were korbonis of the day, not necessarily referred to as the musafin. Says the Gemara, hon yichalamando omar yom kippurim ayel echotu. That's all very good, that if indeed Yom Kippur is also just one ram, in which case it's similar to the Miluim, we can understand that's a reason to learn Yom Kippur from Miluim and not Shavuos from Miluim. Elo lamando omar shnei elim ninu, according to the opinion who says that on Yom Kippur they would bring two rams, ma'ikel meimar. Then what's the difference again between Yom Kippur and Shavuos? And where do we find such machlokes? Tanya, we learned in a braisa, and this is based on the fact that in two psukim, there's one pasuk in Parshas Acharimos, another pasuk in Parshas Pinchas and Sefer Bamidbar, that it speaks about bringing a ram on Yom Kippur. The question is there a Torah speaking about the same ram twice, or is the Torah telling us that there's two rams? So is a machlokes tanoim. Rebbe Omer, Ayel Echot Hu Ha'omur Kan, Hu Ha'omur B'chumish Hapkudim, the same ram referred to in Parashas Acharei Mos, is the one mentioned in Sefer Bamidbar, which is called the Chumash of Pkudim, where Klal Yisrael were counted at the beginning of Chumash Bamidbar, and then Chumash Bamidbar in Parashas Pinchas, it's the same ram as in Parashas Acharei Mos. However, Rabbi Eliezer ben Reb Shimon, he argues, Omer, he says, Shnei Elim Heim, it's two separate rams. Echot Ha'omur Kan, one which is mentioned in Parashas Acharei Mos, Ve'echot Ha'omur B'chumash Pkudim, and one mentioned in Parashas Pinchas in Sefer Bamidbar. So the Gemara is saying that according to the opinion, according to Rabbi Eliezer ben Reb Shimon, then that on Yom Kippur there were two rams, then like Shavuos were two rams, according to him, why are you assuming that Yom Kippur is similar to Miluim more than Shavuos? Maybe Shavuos is the day that we learn that needs Miluim, and not Yom Kippur. Says the Gemara, no. Afilo Tamer Rabbi Eliezer ben Reb Shimon, even according to Rabbi Eliezer ben Reb Shimon, who says that indeed there were two rams, Hosam, however, only one of them, Chad, is Lechoivas Hayim, was for the day, not for the Musaf. V'chad l'musafin, and only one of them was for the Musaf. Lafuke Atzeres to Tarvayu Chayvas Hayim Ninhu. By Shavuos, everybody says there were two rams that were Chayvas Hayim. However, by Yom Kippur, everybody agrees there was just one that was Chayvas Hayim, and therefore, even according to Rabbi Eliezer ben Reb Shimon, the Yom Kippur is more similar to Miluim than Shavuos is. Continues the Gemara. Okay, so we've understood why you don't want to compare and learn Shavuos from Miluim, because Shavuos has two Elim. Right, okay, let's move to the next Yom Tov. Ve'ema Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah also deprishas Shiva l'yom echod. Rosh Hashanah also, strictly speaking, Rosh Hashanah is only one day. The only reason that we have 2 days Rosh Hashanah is for reasons discussed elsewhere in Shas, but intrinsically Rosh Hashanah is just one day. That it's a 7-day separation in preparation for one day, similar to Miluim. So again, the question comes back. Why does our Mishnah say that the Kohen had to separate himself 7 days before Yom Kippur? Learned from this Pasuk that there's a time which is a type of a korban, a lechapir, where you need 7 days prisha. Maybe it's not Yom Kippur, maybe it's Rosh Hashanah. Answers the Gemara, Omer Abavo. There's going to be two answers. The first answer is Abavo. Abavo says, Donim par v'ayil sheloi, Bipar v'ayil sheloi. There was a similarity between Yom Kippur and the Miluim, in as much as that the ox and the ram actually belonged to the Kohen Gadol. How lafuke atzeres, however, and there's a discussion why atzeres is mentioned here. We've already finished with Shavuos, but we'll read the Gemara as it is in front of us. The atzeres v'Rosh Hashanah, however, regarding Rosh Hashanah, the tziburin, the korbanos of Rosh Hashanah, belong to the community, belonged to the entire public, to the tzibur, and therefore it was not similar to Miluim. And therefore, we prefer to learn from Miluim something similar, namely Yom Kippur. Says the Gemara, Honi chalamanda omar, that's all very good. That's only according to the opinion that indeed by Miluim, the korbonis, the paravail, actually belonged to Aaron HaKohen. But we're going to see this machlekas. According to this opinion, we think there might be an opinion that says by Miluim that it was not belonging uniquely and privately to Aaron HaKohen, it belonged to the Tzibur. Then again, the Miluim will be more similar or as similar to Rosh Hashanah than not Yom Kippur. Yom Kippur is Misheloi. So let's see that inside. Honach nichaleman to Omar kach lecho mishelcho. When it says in the pasuk, vayoyme el Aaron kach lecho egel ben boko lechatos va'ay lo'ilot mimim v'hakriv lefnei Hashem by the miluim. It says kach lecho, take for yourself. So according to the man to Omar, who says that lecho means mishelcho, it should belong to you, it's yours. Va'asei lecho, and when the pasuk says that asei lecho shtei chatzotzeres, it's another example, make for yourself two trumpets of silver, of kesef, mikshot, etc., that if you learn that l'cho means it should belong to you, mishalcho, then we can understand miluim, the par v'ayil, belonged to Aaron HaKohen, as with Yom Kippur, it belonged to the Kohen Gadol, and therefore we learn Yom Kippur from miluim, but on Rosh Hashanah, over there we assume that it belonged to the tzibur. Elo lemando oma mishal tzibur, according to the opinion who says that even when it says l'cho, it doesn't mean it should belong to you. It means you should take it, but it belongs to the tzibur. It's bought from the money of the tzibur. And if so, then by miluim, it was bought from the money of the tzibur. Ma'ikele meimar. And then the question comes back, why are you learning Yom Kippur from the Miluim and not Rosh Hashanah? And where do we see such a machlokes where the lecha actually means yours privately, or lecha means belonging to the tzibur? So Tanya, we learned in the Braisa. The Braisa says, kach lecha mishalcha. Whenever it says kach lecha, it means mishalcha, it should belong to you. Vasei lecha mishalcha. When it says vayikhu elecha, which is in plural tense, vayikhu, you, plural, should take mishal tzibur. Then it's talking about take it from the tzibur. That's the Rabbi Yashio. That's what Rabbi Yoshi holds. Rabbi Yonason Oimer, Rabbi Yonason argues and says, Bein kach lecha, bein vayikhu elecha, mishal tzibur. Even when it says kach lecha, it doesn't mean it should belong to you. It means you take, but it should belong to the tzibur. So according to Rabbi Yonason, we're going to have this question that by miluim, it belongs to the tzibur. And what's the difference between why we're learning Yom Kippur from miluim and not Rosh Hashanah? The Braisa continues, according to Rabbi Yonason, that lecha actually means that it belongs to the tzibur. Why indeed does the pasuk say kach lecha, you should take, which seems to be a single tense? It's as if it's belonging to you as an individual. So kaviyachol, so to speak, that Hashem is saying that there are certain cases that mishalcha ani l'reitza yaisa mishalahem, that even though I'm taking it from the tzibur, and it is a korban tzibur, but is, so to speak, he's saying that I'm treasuring and appreciating the korban of the tzibur as if it was yours privately. So to speak, Hashem appreciates the korban of an individual even more than that of the public. So it says, kach lecha, take it belonging to the tzibur, says Rabbi Yonason, and I'll appreciate it, says Hashem, so to speak, as if it was yours personally. That's how the Ritva explains this. So that's the opinion of Rabbi Yonason. The Braisa continues, Abba Chonon Omar Mishum Rabbi Eliezer. Abba Chonon says that, and it seems that Rabbi Eliezer actually holds like Rabbi Yonason. Like kach lecha means it belongs to the tzibur. But he's going to ask another contradiction, and based on that contradiction, he will answer the question, why, according to Rabbi Yonason, does it say lecha in single tense? Kosov echodomer, one pasuk, it says, v'asisa lecha aroin eitz. When you make the aroin, make it for yourself. That seems to mean belonging to you, privately. V'kosov echodomer, in another pasuk, it says, v'asu aroin atzei shittim. That you, plural, should make it. It seems it belongs to the public. Ha keitzad, how would we understand that? Kan bizman sheyishol oisim ratzon shel mokim. When Klal Yisrael are doing what Hashem wants and they're tzaddikim, then it's va'osu, then it's appreciated that it's coming from the public. Kan bizman she'ein oisim ratzon shel mokim. However, when Klal Yisrael are not following Hashem's ways, not doing what Hashem wants, then in that case, Hashem, so to speak, prefers the korban of the yochid. So Abba Chonon was explaining, when does Hashem prefer, so to speak, the korban of an individual over those of the tzibur, is only when the tzibur is not following Hashem's ways. So that's the end of the Braisa. But what did we see in this Braisa? According to Rabbi Yonason, kach lecha means mishal tzibur. So the question comes back, that according to Rabbi Yonason, by the miluim, the power of ail of the miluim belonged to the tzibur. In which case, the question comes back, why don't you learn from miluim to Rosh Hashanah, that Rosh Hashanah should need 7 days of prisha, and why do you choose that Yom Kippur should need the 7 days of prisha? Answers the Gemara, no. Ad kan repligi, when does Rabbi Yoshia and Rabbi Yonason argue as to what the meaning is of lecha? Elo bekicha is the alma, when it says kach, in general places. Va'asiyah is the alma, we'll soon see what they are. And when it says va'asey, and do, and make, when in other places. For example, kicha is the alma, when does it say kach? Kach lecha samim, when it's talking about the spices, you, lecha, you should take the spices. It says machlekas, the kundrabiashia means take it from yourself, it should belong to you. Rabbi Yonason says it should belong to the public. Asiyah is the alma, when does it say asay in general places? Asay lecha shteicha tzoytzeris kesef, when Hashem said make for yourself 2 trumpets, 2 silver trumpets, then there's a machlekas, does it mean belonging to you or not? Aval Hanoch, however, over here, in the case of Miluim and the case of Yom Kippur, even though it would seem that it says Lecha, or it would use the tense, a single tense, however, over here, Hanoch pirushe komefarish. It's almost explicit, d'mishel chohu, that it means belonging to you privately and not to the tzibur. And even Rabbi Yonasan will agree to that, and therefore the question, there'll be no question, and the answer the Gemara gave before, saying that miluim and Yom Kippur both belong exclusively to the yachid, to the kohen, that the answer is a good answer, even according to Rabbi Yonasan. Where do we find explicitly by miluim and Yom Kippur that the korbanos should belong to the individual, to the kohen? But miluim mech deksiv. What does it say in the pasuk by miluim? It says in the pasuk, ve'el b'nei Yisrael tadaber lemoi. Speak to Klal Yisrael and say as follows, kachu, in plural tense, kachu sir izim lechatos, take a goat as a chatos. And then the pasuk says, vayomer el Aaron, Hashem said to Aaron, kach lecha. And this is a pasuk earlier, one pasuk before, it says, kach lecha, egel ben bokor lechatos, that you should take the egel, so the apostle clearly differentiates and once writes kachu and then and also writes lecha. So the fact that the Torah switches the terms, it must be in order to tell us that kachu, means coming from the public. And when it says lecha, I mean lecha. Because otherwise it would have, if lecha means mishel tzibur, then the Torah would have used the same term, kachu, twice. It wouldn't have changed the term. That's what the Gemara says. Well, Bnei Yisrael dabelim kachusirizim lechatos. Vayemel Aaron kach lecho egel ben boko lechatos. Lomoli, why does the Torah change from kachu? Once it says kachu, once it says lecho. Shma mino kach lecho mishel chohu. To tell, to impress on us that everybody has to agree to this, that regarding the miluim, it has to be a korban belonging to the kohen. The korban way it says kach lecho. B'yom HaKippurim, what's with Yom Kippur? Mech Tuksiv, what does it say in the Pasuk? The Pasuk says, B'zois Yovoi Aaron el HaKodesh, B'par ben Bokor lechatos v'ay lo'ayla. And the next Pasuk, the two Pasukim later, U'me'eis Adas B'nei Yisrael, and explicitly take it from the Adas B'nei Yisrael, from the community of Klal Yisrael, Yikach Shnei Sireizim lechatos v'ay l'echod lo'ayla. And what does it say in the next Pasuk? The next Pasuk says, V'hikriv Aaron es parachatos asher loy, belonging to him. So again, we have a switch. It goes from umeis b'nei Yisrael yikach to echatos asher loy, belonging to him. Lomoli, why does the Torah change the term? Shma minot impress on us that hay loy, when it says loy, mishaloyhu. It has to belong to him as an individual. It has to be privately be owned by him. And that's what the Gemara said before, that with Yom Kippur, similar to Miluim, where these korbanos belong uniquely to the Kohen, and that's why we learn the Chiyuv Prisha, Yom Kippur, from Miluim, and not Rosh Hashanah. Continues the Gemara. That was the answer of Rebavo. Rebavo answered, why do we learn Yom Kippur from Miluim and not Rosh Hashanah? He said, because Yom Kippur, the par va'ayil, is Mishaloi, like with the Miluim, and not Rosh Hashanah. That was one answer. There's another answer now, Rav Ashi. Rav Ashi says, no. Donin par lechatos v'ayil lo'ilo. It's not about who the animals belong to, it's rather what the animals were used for. Yom Kippur, the ox was a chatos, and the ram, the ayil, lo'ilo. The par. It's not the ox. The par was lechatos v'ayil lo'ilo. And that is mipar lechatos v'ay lo'ilo, similar to the miluim, where the par was used lechatos, the cow was brought as a chatos, and the ayil, the ram, was used for an oilo. Lafuki Rosh Hashanah v'atzeres, but Rosh Hashanah and Shavuos was different. Tarvayu oilis nidnu. The par and the ayil, they were both brought as a korban oilo. And therefore you cannot learn, or we prefer to learn Yom Kippur from miluim rather than Rosh Hashanah. Continues the Gemara, Ravina Omar. And Ravina is now going to answer all the questions at once. Because we asked, why are you learning Lechapir to tell us that Yom Kippur needs Prisha like Miluim? What about the Korbanos Yochid? What about the Regolim, the Yomim Tovim? And we've gone from one to the next. Pesach, Shavuos, Shmini Atzeres, Pesach, Sukkos, Shmini Atzeres, Shavuos, Rosh Hashanah. Ravina is going to have one answer that answers all of them. Says Ravina, Donin Avoida. He says, you know what Yom Kippur has similar to the Miluim, which all the others don't have, that they were both done exclusively by the Kohen Gadol. Because all the other suggestions that we had besides for Yom Kippur. All the other suggestions were korbanos brought by other koyanim, not necessarily the kohen gadol, and it's not similar to miluim. Another version, Omar Ravina, Donin Avodah Tchilah. So it's saying a quite ambiguous term, which the Gemara is about to discuss, that Yom Kippur is called Avodah Tchilah. At first, a beginning, we don't yet know what this means. Me'avodah Tchilah, and we learn that from Miluim, which was also a beginning. Lafuke Hani, in contrast to all the other suggestions, Delav Tchilah Ninu. They are not considered as being Tchilah. Asks the Gemara, my tchila, what tchila are you referring to here? Are you going to say that Yom Kippur and Miluim have a first, a beginning, which are associated to the Kohen Gadol? That means Yom Kippur is the first avoider of the korbanos tzibur that was given uniquely to the Kohen Gadol. The Miluim was the first avoider, not of the korbanos tzibur, they were his own. But it was the first avoida bichlal that was given to Kohen Gadol. And since both Miluim and Yom Kippur was the start of Kohen Gadol, therefore those are the two that are compared to each other. Is that what the second version meant? Hainu kamaisa. Then, for all intents and purposes, it's as if saying that these two belong to Kohen Gadol, in contrast to all the others, and that's the same as the first version, that Yom Kippur and Miluim are similar, that they're both done by the Kohen Gadol. Elo, what Ravina in the second version must have meant is Avoida Tchilo Bamokim. There's something unique, not about who's doing the Avoida, but where. That both the Yom Kippur and the Miluim, they were both the start of a new place of Avoida. With the Miluim was the first time Bechlal. That Avodah was done on the Mizbeach, in the Mishkan. That's what the inauguration of the Mishkan was. Yom Kippur is the first time that Avodah was done in the Kodesh HaKadoshim, Lifnai veLifnim. And therefore, they have something in common, and therefore we learn Yom Kippur from Miluim, and not any of the other suggestions. Continues the Gemara. Ki Asa Rav Dimi. Rav Dimi now said in the name of Rabbi Yochanan, that Masni Choda. From the pasuk that we learned from Miluim, as we saw in Daf Beis Amud Aleph, that the pasuk says Kasha also by Yom Hazeh, in the same way as you saw by the Miluim, namely that this prisha Tziva Hashem Lasis Lechaper Aleichem, Hashem commanded that it should be also done Lasis Lechaper Aleichem. Till now we learned what Lasis is telling us that by Pora Duma you need the prisha, and Lechaper is telling us that by Yom Kippur needs a prisha, and it happens to be that on Daf Beis Amud Aleph we saw that in the name of Rabbi Yochanan, and the Gemara is soon going to deal with that. But what's it saying now in the name of Rabbi Yochanan? That Masni Choda. He says no, from that whole posuk of Lasis Lechaper Aleichem, Tziva Hashem Lasis Lechaper Aleichem is not two things, Yom Kippur and Pora Duma, it's just one. Rabbi Shua ben Levi, Masni Tarata. Rabbi Shua ben Levi says it's two, like we saw before, it's two. Rabbi Yochanan Masni Choda. What's the one that Rabbi Yochanan learns? La'asis lechaper, elu ma'asiyim makipurim. He says that the whole posuk is referring to Yom Kippur, and then we'll have to know what's the source that you need Prisha by Paraduma. Rabbi Shua ben Levi, Masni Tarati. He says, like we said before, that from this posuk you learn two things, la'asis elu ma'asiyim poro, la'asis is for the Paraduma, and lechaper elu ma'asiyim makipurim, as we saw in Daf Beis Amud Aleph. Says the Gemara, Rabbi Yochanan Masni Choda. Rabbi Yochanan says that you only learn from the pasuk one thing, that like Miluim needed Prisha, Yom Kippur needs Prisha. Ho'anan tanan, but we learned explicitly, Shivas Yomim Koidim Yom HaKippurim, which was our Mishnah on Daf Beis Amud Aleph, v'Shivas Yomim Koidim Sreifas HaPorah, which is the Mishnah in Porah that the Gemara brought on Daf Beis Amud Aleph. And you can't argue with that Mishnah. So even you, Rabbi Yochanan, you have to agree that there is Prisha before doing the Porah Aduma. Well, if you don't have a pasuk, where do you learn it from? Says the Gemara, you're right, I don't have a pasuk, and the prisha by paraduma is not a biblical requirement, it's a rabbinical one. Why? Maila ba'alma. This is the higher standards required when making the paraduma midrabanon to counteract the fact that we were metame the kohen with the sheretz, as we saw in Daf Beis, in order to make a statement against the tzidukim that didn't believe in the oral Torah, they would make the Kohen Tomei with the Sheretz, and then he would go to the mikveh. He would be a Tvul Yoim, but he would do the Porah Aduma, in order that people shouldn't be lax with the halachas of Tyre of Porah Aduma. Therefore, there were many other stringencies were taken into account. We saw some of them on Daf Beis. And here's another one. The concept of 7 days of separation was a rabbinical stringency in order to make sure that people wouldn't be lax with the halachas of Tara of Parah Aduma. Asks the Gemara, Va'omer binyumi bar chilki omer mechasya bar idi, omer b'yechanon. It was said in the name of Rabbi Yechanon, and we saw this on the Beis Amud Aleph. Kasha also b'yom hazeh tziva Hashem la'asos lechaper aleichem. From this pasuk, la'asos eilu ma'aseh paro lechaper eilu ma'aseh yom kippurim. We saw explicitly on the Beis that Rabbi Yechanon says you learn two things from the pasuk, yom kippur and parah aduma. And here you have Rav Dimi saying in the name of Rabbi Yechanon he learned only yom kippur from the pasuk. Says the Gemara, Hahu, this that we saw on Daf Beis Amud Aleph, it wasn't Rabbi Yechanon's own opinion, the Rabbi, it was his Rebbe Rabbi Shmuel's opinion. Dechi also Ravin, Omer Rabbi Yechanon, Mishum Rabbi Shmuel, it was Rabbi Yechanon who said in the name of Rabbi Shmuel, La'asos Eilu Ma'aseh Paro, Lechaper Eilu Ma'aseh Yom HaKippurim, similar to what Rabbi Shua ben Levi learned. But that's, it's not a contradiction, Rabbi Yechanon. One was his own opinion, and one was the opinion of his Rebbe. And Emir Tz Hashem, in the next shir, we're going to continue from here.